The limo driver, I'm standing here with my man, Mike Wilks. Man, Mike, man, this is a beautiful day, man, for a person who really cares about folks giving back, man. Tell me how you feel about the event today and what inspires you to come to these things.
The event today is awesome. ECI, MCA, you know, putting this together. This is awesome event, a way to give back to the community. So I believe to whom much is given, much is required. God has blessed me tremendously, and I feel it's my responsibility to give back. We had an opportunity to work with some great kids here. It gives us some encouragement, some life skills. Hopefully, you know, we can give them some tools that will help them reach their potential in life. And so, you know, I was once sitting in their shoes. And I know that I wouldn't be here today had not people took the time to sow into my life. And so I feel it's my duty and obligation to do the same.
Well, just from you mentioning that, man, thinking about that, so the people that's out there that's not athletes or what do you call big-time lawyers or doctors or somebody in that, tell them how they can also impact youth lives and being an inspiration to them.
A lot of the youth nowadays, they just need positive role models, especially positive male role models. Especially like where I come from, where you have a lot of kids growing up without father figures. So whenever there's an opportunity for a male to be a positive role model in a kid's life, that's huge. And you don't just have to be a man, it's men and women. But our kids today need positive role models, positive influences, encouraging them to make the right choices and decisions in life so they can reach their potential.
Well, you know, like you said, you know, it's amazing that you're 5'11", right? You know, and the fact is we think about most ball players that are bigger than you, and the fact that it was harder for you to accomplish what you did because the odds were against you. Tell me how you looked at those odds each and every day and just overcame it.
I think the odds for anybody that wants to be a professional athlete, whether you're 5'11" or 6'5", are pretty hard. As I explained to the kids, we got 29 NBA teams and most 15 guys on the roster. That's 435 jobs for the entire world. So the odds of making it to the NBA are like hitting the lottery. So, you know, I feel extremely blessed and thankful to have the opportunity that I have to be a part of the NBA for 7 seasons. And for me, you know, overcoming odds, not just in dealing with the NBA, but just in life in general, it boils down to my faith, my belief in Christ, and believing that I can do all things through Him. So, you know, with God, all things are possible. So with man, it may be impossible. With God, it's possible. So looking at those odds, yeah, they may be some high odds, but I always just put my trust in God and work as hard as I can and try to be and become the man that He wants me to be. And I feel like good things are happening in my life.
Well, you know what, you're just for the record, good things have happened in your life, and that's just a testament to man, God, you know, and the faith and the belief in that, man. All we want to say right now is God bless you. We thank you, man, for being that type of role model, being in the community. Like I said, hey, man, it's taking time out of your day, but you seem like that you enjoy it. It's a beautiful thing, and most folks don't understand giving back is a joy. I know you can speak on that, too.
Absolutely. It's nothing like that fulfillment that I get from being able to pour into a young kid's life. And, you know, I see myself in there. So, man, it's definitely a great system of fulfillment and a joy that I get. You know, I feel like at the end of the day, I got more out of it than the kids do. So, I'm truly blessed.
I can agree with you on that, man. It's been a pleasure again, man. Thank you, man.